yo, it's like funny. I came out here to do music. A lot of people tell me, like, why you move to California? You know, this and that. There's more opportunity out here. You know, we, you know, growing up in Queens, Kale's from Brockton, but with New York hardcore. I've always been hardcore. I had a visual back then when I came out here, first time 2001 by myself. I came out here and I tried to get like Scarhead up on some stuff. I wanted to do the same thing Soul Assassins did with their crew and their music, like with House of Pain and Funk Dubious and Cypress Hill. So with the DMS thing, I did the same thing. I came out here, I got fucking La Coca Nostra together. You know, so we got Big Left, Danny Boy, and Slain, part of DMS, in the band with Everlast and Ill Bill. So the Coco Nostra is the big thing. I got the hip hop. I also got Jamie, Hatebreed, Madball, you know what I mean? So we got the best of underground hardcore and best of like whatever white trash crossover metal hardcore, you know what I mean? So, and stuff I'm doing, you know, Tim Armstrong is producing my stuff, you know. I'm working with Dante Ross. I'm working with, you know, this song Everlast. I'm working with people who won Grammys, you know what I mean? So I think I accomplished a lot the past couple of years, you know what I mean? So, but we're now a little lovely Pico Union. Look how beautiful it is. Look at pictures up there. But yeah, I met a lot of friends, like Sick Jacket from Cycle Realm.
Right.
Yo, that's my man. This is his neighbor. He grew up in. So when he came out here, it's the biggest gangbanging neighborhood in Los Angeles. So when he came in here, he was like, yo, I can't believe you live here. His face is horrible. Look at this. Look at this.
It looks like a Queens house, man.
It does. Look, exactly. Come on. Yeah, it's, you know, that's why I came here.
I feel like I never left. I don't know.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry about the eye. But Ajax, you know, climbs trees and just kills things. You know, like woodchucks, possums, raccoons, anything, skunks. But I guess karma. He killed, caught too many bodies. And that's what happened. He took his eye. He's like, fuck it. He didn't even care. I picked him up from the fucking, from Pennsylvania. I wanted to kill my ex-fiance, the one that ran me over in the car. Fucking whore.
Wait.
This is dirty whore.
Wait, now you gotta go back. So you
have to, I got ran. Well, this is what happened, right? It's just some crazy stuff. Some stuff I had in my life. In 2003, I actually tried to become a normal civilian, and I moved out to like by Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, Amish. And Ajax loved it. Seven acres of land. Ajax had two eyes. One was like a crystal white, bluish. It was the prettiest eye in the world. And of course, you know.
They had to take that one.
But he loved it, so he climbed the tree and got poked with a fucking branch, and this fucking stupid bitch didn't bring it to the vet. And I was in the studio, and I was like, hey, because I went back to my mom's in 2003, like, you know, my tail between my legs after I got engaged to this fucking whore. So fucking, you know. And she called me, hey, I'm gonna pick up Ajax. And she calls me back crying. Like, his eyes gone. I'm like, what? So I had a code for the phone. So I listened to messages. The ophthalmologist in Philly for dogs was like, yo, what's wrong with you? There's an infection that couldn't take care of. Basically, Ajax eye got infected. She didn't do anything. It got this big, he ripped it out. So basically, you know, I know, it's a touchy subject, Ajax, I know. Sorry.
We'll blow up and get you a glass one.
We're going to get a glass one. A glass of diamonds. We're going to blow up. Diamond eye, we're going to go. I got signed by Travis Barker, signed me to LaSalle Records for the past year. I've been living off, like, I did an EP, and I want to say thank you, Travis Barker. I'm in a band called Ice Pick now with Jamie from Hatebreed, and it's on Stillborn Records, and that's a big thing. Jamie and I did it. I did the vocals in 4 hours, you know, after my record release party, so I was pretty banged out. I had to drive 4 hours to Hadley, Massachusetts. Zeus produced it. Great guy. But I'm just working on Danny Diablo and Shot Blockers. That's why. That's my main thing. Ice Picks on my downtime, doing another Scarhead record, because Puerto Rican Mike wants something to do, you know, besides sniffing coke and chasing fat white bitches.
But look at you, man. You look a little different than you did in 95.
Yeah, yeah.
You got a little more ink on you. That's,
yeah,
sure.
I guess. Look, see?
Jesus Christ.
The pit bulls, like one has one eye like Ajax.
Does it?
Hold on.
Oh, awesome.
But yeah, I'm getting my whole head tattooed full of pimples and stuff.
So in 95, there's a very famous line.
The fire hydrant thing, huh?
No. There's a fire hydrant thing. There's also what you said about Rick.
I just saw Rick. You know, We played Maryland.
Oh, Rick to Life?
Yeah, Rick to Life was there. And he, you know, it was good to see him. Rick looks the same. Actually, looks a little bit stockier. He has a kid, too, so that changed his life. So good for him, man. Yeah.
But back in 95, you were talking about him. You're like, oh, he look at him with the tattoos. Look at him with the hair. And now,
yeah, but look.
Now you beat him.
Hell no. That's shit in his face still. You know, like, but yeah, I don't got no piercings or anything, man.
He doesn't have the head tattoo, though.
But he has that fucking ugly ass head.
You actually came to Chicago with us, didn't you?
Yes.
And we had the...
with Sheila, Mexico for Sheila.
That's right.
Hi,
right.
Sheila.
When we were in a festival over there. So that was actually kind of cool.
That was cool. And it's funny because being like walking out, people, you know, shaking hands and everything. You know, must have felt good for you, man. You know, people, your thing, you created it. Right? So, you know what? It's funny because I got the VHS tape and I gave it to my, the woman, my love, Liz. Hi, Liz. That's the girl that, you know, I want to have babies with and everything. But she's like, yeah, I'm too crazy. I'm sorry. But I gave it to her and she never knew me back then. So it's like people like, they see it, they're like, hey, you're in the documentary. It's funny, you know? So I'm like, yeah. And was like, oh, you made me laugh. So it's funny. Mike and I are really funny guys. It gets together, so it's horrible. It's like, I can't believe people even managed us. Poor Von Lewis. Probably gave him like a heart attack, aneurysm, whatever. I'm happy with her way to portray everything. Like, it's funny because Mike and I, Puerto Rican Mike and I, weren't in Scarhead together at the time. But then we became in Scarhead together and became best friends. We had the same birthday, too. How crazy is that? And our uncles know each other. They were both bums, like Uptown.
Oh, shit.
Not bums, you know, just drank a lot.
Really?
Yeah. I'm gonna smack the shit out of you. I love you. So Jason looks great. He looks better now than he did back then. Swear to God.
Wow, really?
Vegan, you know, like, he's not retarded. It's like he's like little, like, yo, Jason's. When I see him, I'm playing around with Jason, but he looks great. He looks amazing. He looks 20 years younger, and he's like, yo, coolest guy. He's cool, so less stressed, I think. You know? He's high stress back then, but then again, he had a little baby. His daughter's fucking like 16 years old.
Wow.
People don't even know me. Like, don't even know the music. Say, oh, it must be like thug music. No, Crown Thorns was like very emotional music. It was related to most of the music. Reminds me of Rush. You know what I mean? And you know, it's like very, like, I'm very proud of Crown Thorns. The lyrics at the time, but it was always a fucked up time in my life. And, you know, every time that happens, you write better. You know? Yeah, well, the documentary, you know, it was good. Like, I seen the dude, the 108, the Christian dude, Rob 108. I seen him like twice or something. And I remember he had a house in Jackson Heights. He was like, they moved. So I talked to him. I talked to a lot of people that like, it's weird. This like, that thing, I thought that thing should be on HBO. You know, like, you know, seriously, it was good, man. You know, it was good. And I'm glad it got recognition, but putting this on DVD, putting it back out, that's the best thing you guys could do. You mean the best thing was like they will see that part of the that time because I basically don't remember shit. All the drugs and women and fucking beating people down. I don't know, man. You know, it's like the last time we did it was talking about my brother. That was so long ago, man. That was like the most tragic thing in my life. But then my father passed away. Also, you know, it's like after that, my father died in '99, coming home from the Vanilla Ice tour. I came 3 days. So imagine if I was on tour with Vanilla Ice, my father died, that'd have been horrible. But I came home 3 days earlier, right? And it was my mother's birthday. Came pick me up at the Scarhead house, 3140. Ajax was a puppy. Ajax barked at him when he walked in, like really weird, like a cry. It's really weird, man. The weird day. My father's like, hey, it's your mother's birthday, what the fuck are you doing? And we were partying all night, so Lash was there, you know. Last, so we came. He touched his chest. I was like, "What you doing?" My father smiled at me. It was it. Went to the house. I went to lay down. Called Hoy. Said, "I'm home." Boom. Fell down. Died in my arms. And it's funny. It's really fucked up because he died in my arms, 5 feet away from where fucking my brother killed himself. In the same house. My mother's still there. You know what I mean? It's really weird. So I basically didn't want to be around the house. And my mother, she won't leave that. You know what I mean? But it's the weirdest thing in the world, but I'm glad that my father, you know, like, that at least, you know, I was the last person he saw, you know, say goodbye. Yeah, but my father was the hardest guy in the world, but it was really weird to see someone, because like, it was like, when you die, something like, I think, you know, painless, whatever. When my father died, it was really weird, because I saw the life come out of his eyes, you know, I see him mouth to mouth, and so he tried to say something, I don't know if it was a scream, he was scared, or if he was trying to say goodbye to me, but I saw the life go out of his eyes. It was the worst thing in the world, and that's it. And my poor mother was thinking he was still alive, you know what I mean? Like, you know, like, because they still took him to the hospital, you know what I mean? And I was like, yeah, I didn't want to have him. I could have the heart to say it, but I knew, you know? So, I would like to thank all my friends for being by me. That's how, by the last few years, I'd like to thank all my friends, because we have a good support group, you know what I mean? Like, you know, we're a little fucked up to be in the hardcore scene to begin with, you know what I mean? That's why we're all misfits. But everyone has a lot of good people there, a lot of fucked up people, you know what I mean? You know, but there's a lot of good people too in the scene with good hearts. Just a little fucked up in the head, that's all. As you know, we had so many people like in our scene that worked with me, my crew passed away in the past 10 years. Some people, Saab, rest in peace, was playing guitar for me in the last tour. And he just died. You know, rest in peace, Saab, I love you.
I see your whole piece on your neck.
Yeah, yeah. My man, Saab. It's sad, because you know, someone sits here 15 years old, 14 years old, then one day he's just dead. But it's also sad that, you know, that why it happened, you know what I mean? Because like, we grown up and it's our world. People like, oh, like a lot of people, like between Yas, Sammy, rest in peace, you know.
Hips, Mike.
Two Hips, Boston Mike, you know what I mean? Like, from Scarhead, you know, it's just sad, man. Because definitely people say this and that, but basically it comes down to it's drugs, you know what I mean? And it's, boy, that's our world, you know what I mean? Violence and drugs, and that's what it is. But thank God we have an outlet for what we do, because some of these people that said names didn't have that. And, you know, they turn to other means. And that's, you know, and it's in God's hands, you know what I mean? I live now, like, there's gonna be no tomorrow, because, like, anything can happen right now, you know what I mean? So I live the fullest every day. I try to do as much as I can, stay busy and stay focused. If I keep busy all the time, doing so many, I totally forget what's going on. We did the Warped Tour, we got kicked off that for being at the stage manager. Because Mike the Gook took a piss and the guy punched Mike the Gook in the face. And you know, right there, you know, I felt kind of bad, because the guy deserved, you punch someone in the face, you mean, over, you know, someone's peeing somewhere, like on the fence, it's a festival, 103 degrees, and you're like, what are you doing? You punch someone in the face, that's not good, you know, for the tour, you know? I'm just trying to save money and just, you know, the American dream, have a house and a wife and kids, and it's gonna be hard. I'm still, it's any girl that marries me is really fucked up in the head. It must be crazy just as I am, because to deal with me, you know, or deal with anyone in my crew takes a lot, man. And I'm just happy that I'm happy to still be alive. I mean,
that's the truth.
Actually, our kids, the age I'm at, starting to listen to hardcore if I was like a normal guy. Right? Think about it, right?
Yeah.
Okay? I delivered this little bastard. I delivered him from his mother.
Come on.
That's what I got. Had him as a baby. Delivered, they like, there's so many of them. And I got him because he had a little crooked tail. He was all covered in dirt. Like, they came back like 2 weeks later, 3 weeks later, all covered in dirt. He was gray. I thought he was gray. He was a little bastard. He was just running around. Arf, arf, arf. Poor Ajax. He looks good for his age. Look at him. A little arthritis in the hips. Great white. Yeah, it's a great white.
Totally.
His mouth. Right? It's a total great white. He's a good dog, man. It depends how you raise them, you know, like anything else. Not to say that they are dangerous. I can't have Ajax without outside walking around without a leash, you know what I mean? I would never do that, you know? Because they're very protective. They do everything like me. I do everything 110%. I mean, there's no little in between, half assed. So that's what I do with life. Look at that face. Oh, he's an old bastard. Oh, I can't believe him.
You won't jump up there. Are you serious?
Yeah. You didn't want to go.
You want to?
Yeah. Bring him up here.
Old school. Do it old school. Yeah.
Old school. Hey. Hey.
Hey. Hey.
Hey. Get over here. What are you doing? Crazy ass dog. Hey! Hey, Dex.
No,
come here, boy. Come here, boogie woogie. Come here, boogie woogie. Oh, God. Hey, have fun, huh? Have fun. Who's that dog? Who's that dog at the window? How much is that dog in the window? His ear doesn't work. He got bit by something. He's looking, one of his ears goes up, one of his stays down. His eyes, his things bent. He's all fucked up. Poor guy. It's home. Yeah, like, oh, what's this? Hey, kimono. Kimono. Oh, shit. Oh, oh, get him. Get him. Get him. Get him. Yeah, Jack, get him. Get him. He knows what the film rolling. He knows what the film rolling. Get him. Go, go, go. Go. Man. Yeah, he's like, take out my light work. Take out my
Yeah, come on. Hey, Jack, try to go through the quick freeze.
Ajax, put him check. All right, calm down. Calm down. That's a brother. Killer pit bull, look. Killer pit bull. Yeah. He boxes. What? He ain't so swift, but you know, he's a good kill. He's a good doggy. He's a baby, bro. He's a big baby, right? He loves the camera. I'd like to say sorry to all the girlfriends who helped support me through my times and the rough times through the music and the lying and cheating. I'd like to say sorry to Patricia Praska. I'd like to say sorry to Sheila Fontanibi. And, my first love, Barbara Ann. Like, she was the coming out sister. She's doing good too. Like. So when I see her, I'm proud that you people were part of my life throughout the music and helped me where I got. So Patty, Barbara Ann, Sheila, and Liz. You know, I'm very happy. Any others? I don't know. And if I forgot any of you, then
get the list.
Hold on.
I'd like to give a plug to fucking Familiar Clothing Line, 2007. Freddie Madball. Yo, recognize. Hot shit. New year. Boom. DMS, baby. Freddie Madball. New clothing line. Familiar gear. Yo, wear it. Rock it. Boom. Check it out through pitchfork.com. Word.
Wait, when the hell did Freddie start that?
When he got some money for his accent, for his face.
Wait, what?
Look at his face. You can't tell there's an accent.
Stop right, man. I'm out.
Look at the other guy.
Oh, yeah, cute.
Well, now get the inside shot.
What's up, guys?
Dan Diablo. Plug. Who's that fly guy?
Mark, Royce.
Look at that.
I'm on this is my man MQ's clothing, BBB, Cartel.
MQ.
Yeah.
So you look out for this.
For life.
What size are you, man?
I don't know, medium?
Medium? Large? Yeah. This is large, yeah, it's for you. So I say, yeah.
Look at that, man.
This is a tribal clothing, and look who's a handsome devil over there. Come on.
Jesus Christ.
Who's that?
And he's so humble, too.
Humble, look at that.
Very humble.
That's for you, too?
Look at that, man.
Yes,
look at this shit.
But yeah, so I can get the ice pick stuff, but I don't even know what that is, man.
I haven't seen ice picks yet.
I saw it too. Probably a whole bunch of coke on it. Chopping lions all night. Who knows?
Not me. Him.
Ew, what is that? Oh, fucking crazy, huh? But still hasn't changed.
Different city.
My phone's just blowing out. Who's that? Who's on the phone?
Call 917.
Fuck. Hi, I'm getting filmed right now. Remember the guys, my friend Frank came with the Israeli guy to the house where they did the New York Hardcore documentary in 95? They're in my house right now, filming me right now. The camera's on me.
Hi, Mrs. Singer.
Hey, Ruth.
They say hi, Mrs. Singer. Hi. No, he's not there. No. I got fast, right, tomorrow night? For Yom Kippur? All right, so tomorrow I fast, not tonight, right? Tomorrow night I fast. Monday, 3 o'clock. All right, yeah, that's good.
What's that, we got you McDonald's, something fast?
All right, I love you too, mama. But then she goes, how was the Nike event? She goes, like, Toby was skateboarding. He looks old, his hairline's back here. He looks like his hairline's gone, ma.
He salutes like this.
She goes, stop, my mom, go stop. Hold on. Ma, hold on a second. All right, I'll put your speakerphone. Ma,
okay, honey.
Toby's hair is so bad now.
What's wrong with hair?
He's going bald, ma.
Oh, leave the poor guy alone.
Yeah, leave Toby alone, man.
Leave him alone.
Oh,
all right, Mom. I'm sorry. Okay. I love Toby.
Okay, all right. I love you, Danny.
I love you too,
Ma. Okay.
All right.
I'll call you. Well, you should call your sister. Not now, obviously.
All right, I'll call tomorrow, and I'll be forgiven all my sins for a whole year. I love you.
All right. And Danny, when you break the fast, try to be with the Israeli, somebody Jewish that breaks the fast with you.
I will. I'll be with a fellow Jew. I love you. All right.
I love you.
Bye-bye.
I love you, my friend. God bless you. I wish you a good and happy year. Nothing but the best. That you continue being very good for you and good health. Nothing. I wish you, I'm so happy for you that things are going well. I pray to God every day for your success.
Thank you, Ma. I love you, Mama.
I love you. Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. That was my mom.
Oh,
God bless.
God bless. See?
Oh, that was nice.
That's all right. Yo, where's the coke? Where's the coke and bitches?
No, mom. No, Danny, you animal.
Yeah, but yeah. Like, I'm proud. I'm glad. I count my blessings. I'm glad I have my friends and my whole crew to support me. Right, I'm just trying to bring it to the top. And a lot of times, it hasn't worked so great. You know what I mean? And let's keep on going. You know what? It's like anything else in life. You don't succeed once, try again. That's it. Keep on trying. If I wasn't made for it, then I would have fucking been folded up like a little bitch a few years ago. But now I'm just keep on going. You know, can't do anything else. You mean? What? What else am I going to do? Just break people's faces for money? What else am I going to do? On the side? But you mean, what else can I do? Tap dance?
Yeah, you
good. Talent.